Hello and welcome to episode 72 of the covfefe podcast. Sorry, I've got covfefe on the brain. It's the TrueAchievements podcast. I am your host, Rich Stone. I am here with Jack.
Hello.
And Dave.
Hello, nice to have you back.
Thank you, lovely to be back. Been very busy. Not busy playing games though, just busy doing work stuff. But anyway, let's talk about the streams. It has been another busy week. We have done no less than 5 games, although I was only here for one of them. So this is going to be all down to you, Jack.
Ooh, okay.
So these are Mixer streams. Have you spoken about Mixer?
I think briefly.
Yeah, we mentioned it last week.
Okay. So it's not Beam anymore, if you missed the news. It's all Mixer now.
I'm still calling it Beam every time I say it in my head.
Yeah, I'm getting used to it now. We've got like t-shirts, so I'm like wearing those, drinking out of a Mixer mug, wearing my Mixer cap and wristband. So until I remember that it's not called Beam. But our channel is doing very well, isn't it? We're now up to 2,000 plus followers, which is pretty sweet. So let's talk about last Friday then. So I was in Bath, but you were supposed to play Friday the 13th.
Yeah, so we kicked off with Friday the 13th, and it turns out playing an online-only game on the day of release, when we've had some issues getting into the store, isn't a good idea. We basically sat in a lobby for 5 minutes, and then I called it quits and moved on to a different game temporarily while we got two other people to go and download the game. So we did come back to Friday the 13th, but we jumped onto a game called Embers of Mirim, which is one that we had on the release the week before, but we hadn't played yet. And this was a little platform where you were playing kind of cat dragon things. It was like cats with wings. It was a bit weird. It was just moving from either left to right or right to left, depending on the level. Jumping over gaps, if you like fell into water or touched these kind of thorny plants, you'd die. But it had a core mechanic whereby you'd pick up an orb, and that gave you the ability to then split your character into two kind of energy lights, and you could push the left trigger to split them into a green, or the right trigger to split them into a blue, or both triggers at the same time to split them into both orbs, and then you had independent control over those orbs on the left and the right sticks.
Wow.
So you'd come to a section, and you'd have walls that were color-coded to the same colors of the orbs, and only those color of orbs could pass through. So you need to split yourself into those colors, then independently control those with the sticks to get through kind of mazes on each side. So it's like two mazes at the same time on your hands or whatever. And then after you've got through, let go of the triggers and you recombine into the cat thing.
Sounds quite weird.
Yeah, it was very simple up until that point. I was just kind of churning through the level thinking, ah, this is quite easy. And then as soon as it introduced that mechanic, it threw everything up in the air.
Okay, well, you got 11 achievements for 130 gamer score, which is mm-hmm. There must be a lot of achievements in that game.
Yeah.
Okay, and then you did finally manage to play some Friday the 13th, but pretty much only because we were the only people that were playing it in the world.
Yeah, so I think they had, as I said, they had some issues getting onto the store. It was supposed to release, and then it just didn't appear until really late on the day. Loads of people were kind of asking where the link was, how they could get it, and stuff like that, which is never a good sign anyway. But I didn't realise it's all online.
Yeah, no single player.
The premise of the game, though, you play as either counsellors, which are kind of a survivor characters, or a villain, in this case Jason, from the Friday the 13th films. So you're either trying to kill the counsellors or escape and run away. But there was no guidance in it at all. So the survivors actually do have a quest and kind of a task to complete, and if they complete all the things, it's kind of like get fuel for the boat, fix the boat or whatever, if you're on the level where you need to escape on the boat. If you do all of that jazz, then you can get away safely. But the Xbox version doesn't explain any of that. And supposedly the reason for that, the Xbox version's still running the beta version, and the PC and the PS4 versions are many versions ahead of that.
Right, okay.
They have tutorials, they have little extra bits of help and stuff, but there was just nothing in this. So we went into it a little bit blind. It was quite interesting, quite good fun. It was interesting working out what the abilities were, so the tutorial might have taken some of that magic away. It played okay, but it felt a bit clunky, to be honest. And right. It felt very samey, even after kind of three or four matches. It was just the same thing over and over again. And the achievement list is not a good one if you don't like grinds.
Yeah, so we reached out to them about the achievement list based on the feedback we got, and they did say they were going to look into possibly changing some of the requirements, but we haven't heard back from them on that.
I think
it's fair to say that the launch wasn't a spectacular success.
No.
Lots of people saying the game was broken. So we are waiting for a patch, which may have dropped by now, actually. Poor old Mark's trying to do a review of this game as well at the same time. It just doesn't work. So he had a very frustrated time at the weekend trying to review it. But
well, the online
they did promise a patch, didn't they?
Aren't working at all, are they, I don't think? To some degree, anyway. People have been sitting in lobbies for 20 minutes. Yeah, the matchmaking.
Yeah, matchmaking's totally broken. You were able to make a private match. So I think people were using our gaming sessions to actually just get matches together, which is not ideal.
No. You shouldn't have to do that just to play a game.
But. No. So anyway, they were talking about getting a patch out on Tuesday, but I don't know if it ever came. But we will try and find out. But the game is a bit busted at the moment. So I would hold fire before buying it until you've got confirmation that it's working properly.
There was some really funny bits in it. I was playing at Jason at one point, and we were playing with Bex, and she was setting like a trap on the floor. So it appears that all you have to do is crouch down on the floor, and as Jason, I couldn't do anything to actually hit her. It's just wait.
Okay. So did you actually enjoy what you played of it, or was it?
I think it's got
too frustrating.
It's got the potential to be a good game, but it seems almost limited that it's just Friday the 13th. And there's another game coming out soon called, I think it's Dead by Daylight. Or something like that. And that's pretty much the exact same concept, except it's got unlicensed characters or villains in it. I think a couple of licensed ones, but way more people, way more maps, and just seems to be Friday the 13th, but times five.
Okay.
So might be worth waiting and looking into that one.
Okay. That sounds sensible. Okay, then this week you have played Spellspire, which is quite interesting.
Yeah, Spellspire. So I used to play a game way back in the day. Well, that's how I used to play. I think I played it a couple of times, called Bookworm on the PC. It reminded me a lot of that. You are working your way through dungeon towers. There's no kind of interaction with the enemies. It's not real-time fighting or anything. You instead just have a grid of letters, and you're given, I think, 8 letters. And it's basically anagrams at that point. You just need to make words from those letters, make the longest word possible, depending on the...
So you're not actually given a theme or anything, it's any words?
Yeah, it's just any words at all.
Okay.
So we got a couple of pawns and pornos in there.
Excellent. That's obviously the main thing.
Yeah.
And at that point, you stopped.
Yep.
Work here is done.
It was quite interesting to see what words it allowed and to test the limitations.
Try and break it.
It was good fun though, really good fun. Really good to stream something like that as well, getting some really good suggestions from chat. And I found out that I know way more words than I thought I did.
That's good.
I also don't know how to spell that well.
Okay. Just make a list of all the words you know.
Yeah, I should, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
It was good fun.
Okay, so you got 4 achievements for 165 Gs. Is it a... it looked sort of RPG-ish a little bit.
Yeah, so over the top of the game, the core of the game of combat is obviously spelling, and the longer your word, the more damage you do. But at the end of the levels, you earn money, and then you can buy new kind of wands, new cloaks for your character, upgrade all those bits, so it's kind of slow progression the further you
get. Does that make you more dangerous when you're attacking and stuff?
Yeah, increases your power, increases your health, other bits and pieces. But it's just working up, and I couldn't see an end to the number of levels. I think we got to...
100.
Is it 100? Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. It's a lower
level. And you can replay the levels as well in challenge mode. The enemies are 10% quicker, but you get a star at the end and a little bit more money.
Are there achievements tied to that as well?
Not too sure. Okay. It was a fun game though, well worth looking at if you like spelling.
Yeah, it's on sale at the moment as well, so if you're quick you can pick it up, link on the page. Okay, then I had a go, because I've been away for so long, I thought I'd play a game. So on Wednesday I played Tokyo 42, which is an isometric, although you don't have to leave it in isometric because you can actually shift the camera by 45 degrees at all times. You can just keep going around. And it's like a sort of version of Hitman, but very tiny, pixelated graphics. So you're really, really tiny Hitman, in 3D isometric. That's it. I got two achievements. No, it's like you're on top of a sort of city area, so there's like buildings around, and you can jump between them, you can climb upstairs. And the idea is you get given a target at the start of the mission, mm-hmm. and you might need to go and pick up a weapon. There's like shotguns, there's sniper rifles, there's daggers and things like that. And you'll have to position yourself so that you can take out the target, and then you'll go and pick up a reward at the end of it. The controls were reasonably tricky. As I say, you've got this camera shifting around angle. That's on the bumpers. And because you're sort of going around buildings a lot, you have to move the camera around quite a lot so you can see yourself and your enemies at all times. You use the right stick to aim the weapon that you're using. In fact, it was pretty tricky. So you'd click on the right stick to sort of take out the sights, and then you could move a target using the right stick. And then fire using the right trigger. But while you're in that mode, you couldn't really move particularly easily because the camera would stay fixed on your target and you could actually move off the screen so you couldn't actually see your character anymore. It was really sort of quite clunky. But I quite enjoyed it. The levels got more and more difficult, so you had to like take out a guy that was at the top of a building and had loads of henchmen guarding it on the way up, and if any of them spotted you, it would just all kicked off. So you had to try and be stealthy. You could crouch, which was the extent of the stealth mechanic. Which meant that people couldn't really see you. But it was reasonably enjoyable. I only got ridiculously two achievements for 25 Gs in my hour, even though I was pretty dope at the game, as you'd expect. So pretty tricky completion there, I'd imagine, for anyone of a normal ability. And then yesterday we played Dungeon Bros in co-op, which was quite cool. Tell us about this one, Jack.
So this was another platformer, I'd say. Mm-hmm. You played a little dragon. It was Dragon Bros, sorry. Not Dungeon Bros. But you played a little dragon. You could shoot with the right trigger. You had an aim on the left stick, and you could lock your character in position, because left stick was movement as well. So if you held the left trigger, it locked your character in position so you could aim properly. You basically progress through the level. Occasionally you come to an area and a stop kind of hand had come up on the screen.
Yes.
You'd have to kill all the enemies in the area, then you could progress to the next one. It's just kind of a rinse and repeat. And collecting donuts as well.
Yeah, lots of donuts. And we were being sort of sarcastic calling them donuts, because we assumed they were supposed to be rings. Mm-hmm. But then the developer came into the chat and started telling us that they were actually donuts. So that was cool. Unless he was pulling our leg, then they are actually donuts.
I think it's just our amazing knowledge of video games.
Yeah, they did look like more like donuts than rings. So as you collect the donuts, it built up your ultra power, and then you could kick the ultra power in by pressing Y, and that would give you much more devastating attacks.
Yeah.
It was good, though. It was reasonable. It was much more... I wouldn't enjoy it as much playing single player, but playing co-op, it was really good. You could... not revive, but if one of you died, then you could respawn, and it took about like 6 seconds or something for you to respawn. As long as the other person didn't die during that time, you could progress. It was like infinite respawns. But pretty good sort of 2D side-on thing. Reasonably varied enemies. Some of them were quite tricky. You had like a jump attack, didn't you? Which would like jump up and then smash down on some of them, because they wouldn't die by normal bullet fire. Different weapons to pick up. But no, it was reasonably enjoyable. And thanks to the dev for popping in the stream. At the time, there's only 11 achievements in the game, but we did manage to get 4 of them for a massive 300 gamer score. So if you want some quick score and you like a bit of couch co-op, although I reckon you could probably, I don't think any of those 4 that we got were actually for playing co-op. I think they're all just regular progression.
Yeah, and all the stuff was attached to a single controller, wasn't it? So
yeah, player 2 did not unlock stuff, bear that in mind. And that was Dragon Bros. I'm making up new games every day. I'll just mention today's stream. We are going to try a co-stream today. So one of Mixer's cool new features that when they did the rebrand, they announced co-streaming. So you can have up to four streams all on the same page, all sort of hosted in the same channel at once. So we are going to have a go at streaming The Culling, which is a multiplayer, a bit similar to Playground, Player Unknown Battlegrounds, which everyone is going nuts about on PC at the moment. So it's sort of an arena shooter, a bit like, what's that film? A Stroke Book?
Battle Royale.
No. Well, yeah, that too.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
But the one about Katniss. Yes, that's the one. The Hunger Games. A bit like that. So you will start off in a massive thing, and then it's like every man for himself, and the last man standing wins. Last person standing wins. So that should be really good. Hopefully the co-streaming works. But again, we haven't learned from our Friday the 13th woes of last week. This is an online-only game that launches today, so it could go horribly wrong.
It could.
Join us at 3 to find out.
Join us at 3 to watch for chaos ensue. Yeah.
Yeah. Before we talk about what we've been playing, let's talk about why we've been playing those things, Dave.
Okay, yeah. So there's a new community event that we announced early this week, started yesterday, called the Alphabet Challenge. Pretty simple premise. You've got to unlock achievements that start with the letter. So you lock one with the letter A, and then B, and then C, and so on. You've got to unlock them in alphabetical order. Mm. And it's been pretty fun so far, I've got to say.
I've really enjoyed it. Yeah, I started it last night, had a few hours. It's worth mentioning that you don't have to just get these achievements in order. You can get other stuff in between, and it doesn't break the string or anything, as long as you get an A, one that starts with an A, and then you get whatever you want, and then you get one that starts with a B, and then you get whatever you want, and then you get one that starts with a C. It won't break your chain. There's some cool functionality built into the site. So there's obviously the big hub page, which shows the leaderboard and the forums and all sorts of other stuff. But also on your homepage, if you do register this event, and you can register it for it until the end, so there's no like early registration thing, you can register all the way up to the last day. You'll get a panel on your homepage which tells you which achievement you are going for. And then if you click the button, it'll show you which achievements that you haven't unlocked yet in the games you own that start with that letter. So it's worth pointing out that anything that starts with a symbol or a number, they don't count. We're not like stripping off funny characters at the start and then going to the first letter. It's just that first character of the achievement that is the important one. But it's been our most popular event ever. We've had over, I think we're up to 3,100 people that have registered within a day and a half of announcing it, which is absolutely nuts. And we've got about, I think we're up to about 60 people that have completed the list now.
But the good
thing, one guy did it in the first like 2 hours. It's just nuts.
The best thing about is like everybody can win. It's not like everybody other site contests where the first person to do it, or the best person, like wins it. If you do the alphabet, then you're going to get like a cool new badge on your profile page.
Yeah, so it's new badges, and we're going to do more and more of these events. So this is the first community challenge. We're having a special community challenge event. You've got nothing to lose. Anyone can do it. Just register, go and get the achievements. It's really straightforward. You've got plenty of time to do it. It's not stressful. I knocked 5 out in an hour last night. Without really too much effort at all. It's now, shut up you, 62 people have completed their list. And big shout out to Mitt Raelba, who completed his list first. It was done, so the contest started at midnight, and he was done by 2:41. So he took just over 2.5 hours to get all 26, which is pretty sweet. How did you start, Dave, and what are you up to now?
I'm up to H.
Or H, for those that don't put a hurt in front of it.
Fortunately for me, I've got Assassin's Creed, the Ezio collection, so I needed like 300 with A that I could do. I'm trying, though. I'm trying not to, you know, just start throwing random games in and start playing just for one achievement.
So I've been doing that.
I go through games already on my tag, so I've been playing, like, what did I play? Call of Duty 4 on the 360 last night.
Okay.
Pulled out Quantum Break and realised I'd forgot everything in the game. Couldn't remember how to freeze time or anything, but thankfully that's one of the games that's got, like, the achievement tracking in, and I knew that I was quite close to some of them.
Okay.
So, yeah, just a variety. And last night, the last ones I got, I was really lucky. There was one in Watch Dogs 2 that I needed for F. Do you know those scout locations in the game?
Yes.
So there was one that I needed to rank up to unlock a skill where there's, I don't know if you've done it or not, there's one for calling like the police on the donut guy.
Oh, no, I haven't done that yet.
Right, okay.
I have unlocked that skill, though, so I couldn't find the donut guy. I did go and look for him.
Right, you have to go at a certain time of day, I think it is, maybe.
Okay.
But I needed to rank up to unlock that skill, so I was just doing other scout locations. And then as I did that donut guy, I arrested him. And then I thought, oh, I better take a photo quick, otherwise I'll have missed the scout location. So I got the one with F for the police capturing, and then G for taking the photo was my 25th scout location, so I got lucky, really.
Nice. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so I was doing Defense Grid 2, which has an A, really easy A. Unfortunately, it's Arsenal, which I never wanted to put on my tag, but I have it now. And then I unlocked a load of other ones. And you can get that in the prologue, the really early first level. You just need to build 20 towers of the same type. This was a Games of Gold game, I think. I'm pretty sure I never bought it. So that was trivial. And then I got Bon Appetit in Mafia 3, which is for feeding a body to an alligator. Okay. Then I got Confident in Defense Grid 2 again. So I flipped back to that. And that's just for using the speed up three times. Again, did that in the prologue. Then I popped in Rare Replay and got Do You Have Battletoads for my D, which was, again, took 2 seconds. And then finally, I popped in Thomas Was Alone, which I played about four levels of and then got very annoyed with it. But there's one for jumping 1,600 times, which is called Experience Jumper. So I literally just sat there hammering the button, listening to the radio. For about 20 minutes. And they got that's worth a massive 80 gamer score, though.
Nice.
Yeah. So I'm up to F, but I will carry on today. But it's really good fun. In fact, I won't carry on today. I'll carry on over the weekend at some point. But it's really, really good fun, really easy. And I think we're going to try and do more of these sort of really simple ones that anyone can do, because it's effectively a different game for everybody, because, you know, everyone's got their own unique game collection. To pull these letters from. So you've got three and a half weeks or so left. If you haven't signed up, sign up. It does, as I say, it doesn't cost you anything. It's really good fun. I'm going to see how tricky it gets when we get to Q and X. But once you look at the links, you'll be able to see in advance if you can just change the letter in the link to see your locked achievements that start with those letters. So you'll be able to tell where your pinch points are. But yeah, I'm definitely going to try and finish it. And it's not, I reckon most people can do it in probably 6 or 7 hours. But it's just fun putting in old stuff, and
yeah,
it's been cool. So I've just been choosing the Xbox One things. So on your My Achievements page, you can filter out the platforms and various other bits and bobs, exclude the DLC and all that jazz. So lots of fun. Please join. Other site news, we announced the results of the poll for June 2017 TA playlist. And the winner was Sunset Overdrive. I think it won by a reason, probably the biggest margin so far out of any of the votes. So that has just started. So if you want to play Sunset Overdrive, want to finish it, have played it before, now is the time to get into it. I think it just went on sale as well, but that sale might have finished now. But it's a quality game. I really enjoyed it. The only thing is, it takes a while to learn the controls. So I think going back to it is probably going to be tricky for the first half an hour.
Yeah, I mentioned that.
Because it was definitely a slightly odd control scheme. That's it for site news. Dave, what else have we got?
Okay, first one I thought I'd mention, we've got a competition at the minute going on, pretty cool. It's to win a 1-year subscription to Xbox Game Pass and a year of TA Pro. I didn't know this at the time, but people have been tweeting saying that you can only buy the Game Pass subscription at the moment in blocks of a month. So the code seems to be pretty rare. Got one. I'll link to it in the show notes, but you just have to go on. There's the Gleam app. It basically gives you an option so you can just visit a page, subscribe to like one of our channels, Beam, YouTube, follows on Twitter, things like that, and you get entries for each one you do. So the more you do, the better chance you got. But it's been going really well so far.
How many entries are we up to?
11,000.
Wow.
It's a lot of entries, but it's a cool prize.
It is a very cool prize. Yeah, year of TA Pro as well, so you can see how to win all these, complete all these millions of games.
Yeah. Next up, pretty cool. There's Sea of Thieves. They've been doing like testing for quite a while. I think you had to be like an insider. That's Microsoft's word for everything in it. To play the game in like early stages. But now they're actually looking for feedback for the game's achievements, which I think is pretty cool that a developer's actually reaching out and asking. So you can still sign up for the Insider program. We've got a link to that in the story. You can basically just have to wait. It kind of goes out in waves and they keep adding more people in. And then there's a page that on there as well. You can go and give some ideas, maybe cool things you've been doing in the game. Nice. I can't wait to play this one. Hurry up. It's not announced a date yet, though. I imagine that E3 will get a date.
Yeah, we will, for sure. Not long now.
No, what is it? It's like 10 days or something? 9 days?
Yeah. 9 days.
Busy time.
Da-da-da.
We kind of talked about this last week. They've been teasing. They did some short teaser trailers and like the game's key art. But now they've officially detailed and dated Far Cry 5. You're going to be playing against like the enemies. Eden's Gate is like the project. They're like a doomsday cult of weirdos. Yeah. It looks really cool.
The trailer looked brilliant, actually.
Yeah, there was a trailer that looked really good. There was trailers concentrating like on. You're going to have like assistants in the game and there's like three characters. If you watch them, they were only short little trailers, but their stories are pretty interesting. Whole game looks pretty cool, I'd say, so far from what we've seen. And it's going to be coming on February 27th. So not crazy long to wait.
Quite a long time to wait.
We used to get announces for 2 years, 3 years later, didn't we? Yeah, they seem to be doing better. Most companies seem to be lowering a bit. But yeah, I'll link to that. Watch them trailers. Definitely worth checking out if you're interested at all.
I'll definitely get that. Love the Far Cry series.
Just a reminder, 1st of June, obviously, so new games with gold. You've got Speedrunners on the Xbox One throughout the whole of the month. It's now available. I saw somebody saying this today, it's like a quick 800 gamer score.
Okay.
A couple of them might be a bit grindy, but the rest of them are pretty simple and easy. And then Assassin's Creed 3 on the 360, and obviously back compat, that's until June the 15th. I used that yesterday to get one of my alphabet achievements. there's also, I've heard different things about this, there's also a DLC for Phantom Dust. People have said it was free anyway, but they're advertising it on Games with Gold as it's free, so go and get that. And then if you didn't pick up Lara Croft and the Temple of Osiris last month, it is free until the 15th, I think.
Okay. Yeah,
15th of June. Next bit, sad news. A game I was really looking forward to. Middle-Earth Shadow of War. They announced yesterday that it's been delayed. It was originally going to come August 22nd. It is now October the 10th. So, again, it's still not a crazy delay, but...
No, that's fine. And to be honest, most people are going to be waiting to... Well, a lot of people are going to get... This is the first big Scorpio game, wasn't it, really? Mm-hmm. It was the first confirmed. This is going to look amazing in Scorpio. So I don't think anyone was expecting Scorpio to be ready for August. So I'm more than happy to wait for this.
Yeah.
Anyway. Because I'm going to be playing this on Scorpio.
Well, they did say this. I think as well, is that Gamescom time? So we wouldn't have played it anyway.
True.
Unfortunately. But yeah, October 10th. And they're still going to be showing some stuff at E3. So there's still have stuff to whet your appetite. Sonic Mania. Sonic announced two games are coming this year. Sonic Mania is like the more classic, old school looking one. We got a new trailer this week that dated it. It's coming on August the 15th. Okay. So again, not too long to wait for that one. And I'm really excited. That reminds me of sitting playing my Game Gear in bed. Like, try to finish it. Can't wait for that. City Skylines was obviously a popular game. We enjoyed it. Idea Xbox game. Problem was there was four glitched achievements in it. Unobtainable. They've done a patch that fixes quite a few things. There were some save problems. Unfortunately, if you lost your save, there's no recovery. You'll have to start again, but it won't happen again now. Yeah, it's a bit annoying if you put a lot. But the four achievements that were unobtainable, they've said are now fixed. I noticed, I think there was two of the four people had already unlocked when the story went up yesterday. the other two, they might be quite a long way in, I'm not sure.
All of them have been unlocked now, so that's a good sign.
Right, okay. Might actually start it now, because I was excited for that one.
Have you added a fast-forward button yet?
No, I don't think...
they have. That was in the patch.
Was that in the patch? Great.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Oh, even better. Yeah, I'll definitely
start. I read about that. Awesome. Okay, a quick mention for E3. We'll have an E3 hub, as we always do. That'll probably go live. We might put that up today, because we're already getting loads of stories about E3, so it seems silly not to have them hubbed up. We will be doing a live blog from on the day of E3 for the Microsoft conference, at least. We'll probably do some of the other ones as well. We have people on the ground at the show, so that's cool. So they'll no doubt be tweeting from there. Follow the TrueAchievements Twitter account for updates from them. And hopefully we will be live streaming on Mixer, Jack and I, while watching it on my telly at home. So that hasn't been confirmed that we're allowed to restream E3 on Mixer yet, but we should find out this week. Well, we will find out this week, otherwise we'll just do it anyway. And hope that we don't get tagged and taken down. So, loads of content. So if you want to hear Jack and I's opinions or gasps or boos or anything that we do while watching it, then check out our Mixer channel on E3 Day, mixer.com/TrueGamingNetwork. Join one of the other 2,000.
Are you just doing the Xbox One or are you doing the Mar?
We're just going to do the Xbox One, I think. Well, that's the one on Sunday. We'll review that. We need to check the times, actually. Mm-hmm. There is a story up with the times in, so we'll have a look at that. But the live blog will be on site, so that will be like real-time updates.
We always have live chat and all kinds of stuff, don't we?
Yeah, there's loads of stuff. It's going to be really good. We're all very excited about E3 this year. New achievement lists. Jacqueline.
Yeah, I've had quite a lot of it. I've had two bigger titles, I'd say. We've had Tekken 7, 43 achievements, and nice. MXGP 3, the official motocross game. Don't get that confused with the unofficial one. It's big-ish, I suppose.
I've never heard of it.
France, but that's even less big than... that's got 36 achievements.
We've had one big game this week.
One big game. And Tour de France 2017, 28 achievements.
So does he know how that plays? What do you have to like waggle the stick? Is it like an old school?
I think it's is it a Kinect? You have got to swing your arms.
No, it's not.
Oh, I hope so. Or it could be your legs.
I just imagine you just button mashing A or something like that to pedal, and then his stamina is running out, and then he annoyed and win the game. He's pretty much.
I mean, there's a whole series of these games. This is not a new game. This is like the 10th of the series.
But well, when they brought out like back and pattern or something, it'd be like Tour de France 2016.
It's obviously a market for it, because they bring them out every year.
Yeah. Very small market, I think. But okay, then we had Crossout, 13 achievements. Everspace with 25 achievements. Yet another ACA Neo Geo game, Metal Slug 2. Exact same list as all the others. The Town Light with 20 achievements. Constructor with 34 achievements. Get Even with 40 achievements. Platobi the Dwarf Planet Tales, 30 achievements. Dead by Daylight, which I mentioned earlier, with 61 achievements.
Wow.
And Starballs with 43 achievements. And this is, I'm sorry, but a terrible achievement list.
Oh.
It has a couple of achievements for spend 24 hours in levels, not too bad. Spend 50 hours in levels, spend 100 hours in levels, spend 250, spend 500 hours in levels.
Oh. Balls. Yep. Star balls. And then we had a ton of DLC, free DLC for Minecraft.
Yeah, Minecraft, every single version of Minecraft. Got the Discovery Update, 6 achievements for 170 game score on each.
Okay, we haven't got Xbox One version on there, but did that already hit as well?
The Xbox One version hasn't hit, actually. That's okay. The point. So all the versions bar the Xbox One version.
And the Xbox 360.
And the Xbox 360, yes.
But we also got one title update in Lies of Astaroth.
Lies of Astaroth, yes.
Okay, cool. Oh, gosh. Very late in the day. Thank God that's happened. Thought I was going to have to keep the code then for a minute there.
No. So this week we're giving away a code for Punch Club. That was another one we streamed. It was like a time management boxing game.
Boxing sim, yeah.
Rocky with time management. Looked all right.
Yeah, it was. I really enjoyed this game. You can sink a lot of hours into it, I reckon.
Code for this one is C4MK7DWCGJ2FXTT F7999HJKFZ. There you go.
Nice. Lovely. Okay, good luck to anyone that puts that in. Have we got any mailbags?
No, I forgot to do it, to be honest.
Okay, cool. So if you sent a question in, sorry about that. Cool. Let's talk about new releases. So we've got, as Jack said, Tekken 7 and The Culling are out today. We've got next week, we've got DLC Fallen Ghosts for Wildlands, which will no doubt bring more of the same Wildlands stuff. We've also got some Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy Telltale Episode 2 coming out. And then we've got new games, Neighbor Horde, see what they've done there, and The Town of Light, Super Beat Sonic, which I thought looked quite cool, which is a rhythm action game.
Yeah.
Then Zazen Zen Meditation game, which, I mean, this is Kinect, isn't it? I think it's a Kinect game.
Yeah, it's Kinect.
We are so going to have to stream that.
Unfortunately, I don't think it's ID. But...
Oh, it's not ID. I'll just stream it anyway. 23 achievements in that game. And then Refunked, which is next Wednesday. And then it's E3. So you've probably got questions for E3. Anyone, let's do quick predictions for E3. Do we think there's going to be any new IPs? There's got to be new IPs. We need like
I think
Horizon Zero Dawn bashing new IP.
Yeah, I think there'd definitely be new IPs. I was going to say about the... do you think we'll get a Scorpio price or look at the actual console itself?
Yeah, we will definitely get all of that. Yeah. I reckon we'll get all those details.
Hands-on with people, like press at E3 on Scorpio.
With the showcase, yeah, which we are invited to. So we may get hands-on with Scorpio. That's the Monday, I think, that happens. Obviously, Forza 7.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Given, isn't it?
Gears? More Gears?
I don't know.
Too early for Gears. Maybe something. There's not Halo, is there? They already confirmed there was no Halo.
Yeah.
Maybe. We're going to see Crackdown.
Crackdown. Sea of Thieves.
We did think we might see some Red Dead, but given that's been put back, we might not see that now.
I think what else? Yeah. It wouldn't surprise me if we could see it. You know, like some of these that launched earlier on, like maybe Sunset Overdrive or. Rise, you know, like see a sequel to one of them, maybe.
I'd love to see a Quantum Break sequel. Crytek own the IP for Rise, I think, and they are not in business.
Yeah, I think they're in a little bit of trouble. It would be an amazing thing to do, though, because Rise was a launch game on the Xbox One.
Yes.
And imagine if they came out with a Scorpio and went, oh, and launching with the Scorpio is going to be the next iteration of Rise.
See, I just... Microsoft... buys the rights to Rise. I just googled it.
Oh, okay. So, thank you.
Interesting.
I don't know if it's true or not, but that's what it says.
Wicked. Oh, well, that's cool then. And Crackdown 3, we're going to see. any other things? I don't think we're going to see.
Splinter Cell.
Splinter Cell. They haven't done one of those in so long that
is true.
Game changer.
It's a big IP.
Yeah. And I noticed Far Cry, like everything for Far Cry so far has been, PlayStation.
Yeah.
They've got the marketing deal, so you never know. Splinter Cell.
We need something, though. Maybe another new Tomb Raider. There'll be some EA stuff.
I think, because that's Microsoft published, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, we always see some EA stuff, so we'll see some Madden and FIFA and all that.
It wouldn't surprise me if they got some like totally curveballs up the sleeve that nobody knows about.
I hope so. I don't want it to be a boring same old with better
that,
hardware.
This, end of this year, like Crackdown and things just don't really interest me. You know, there's only Sea of Thieves that I'd probably...
Crackdown's been in the works for so, so long, hasn't it?
Cuphead.
So
it's we're supposed to be
coming
Cuphead.
Out on the Xbox years
Cuphead.
Ago.
We're going to see Cuphead and it'll be delayed.
Cuphead delayed till 2018. No, we had it confirmed that it was definitely coming out this year.
Yeah,
it obviously needs for Scorpio graphics.
You need the Scorpio graphics. Yeah. Cool. Okay, well, thanks, guys. We will be back next week with our final pre-E3 podcast.
Pre-3,
nice. Pre-3
just
podcast.
Dropping that in everywhere you can now.
Yeah, pre-3 podcast. And we will also be hopefully much further down the line in our alphabet challenge list. Sign up on the site. There's links all around the site for it. Do it. It's good fun. Thanks for joining us today. We will speak to you again next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you later.